This $5 Wi-Fi outlet is an aquarium controller. This $60 Inkbird, also an aquarium controller. And this $500 Neptune Systems Apex EL, spoiler alert, controller. On the surface of things, a controller controls things. A television remote control controls the television. A drone controller controls a drone. So an aquarium controller must control the aquarium, or at least certain elements of the aquarium. A TV remote doesn't control everything about the television, but it controls certain elements, such as the volume, the channels, and accessing the menu. Similarly, an aquarium controller doesn't control everything about the aquarium, but depending on what you choose, it can control a lot of different elements inside and around the aquarium. Think about it like this. You could probably use a separate controller to control the volume, a separate controller for the channels, a separate controller to control the brightness, a separate controller to do all sorts of things with the TV. Or you could place all of those functions into one controller and make your life easy. That's exactly what an aquarium controller can do for your tank. It can take all of those individual controllers and elements and put them under one element, one controller, making your life much easier. One really confusing thing in this hobby is the difference between a controller and a monitor. We often muddle these two things together in this hobby, which can be super confusing for beginners. Most controllers monitor something, but monitors don't control a thing. Let's take a quick peek at our website. Controllers and monitors share the same webpage, which can make it difficult for a beginner to distinguish between the two. For example, this kilowatt power strip merely monitors power consumption. While this Neptune EB8 bar also monitors electricity, it can also turn the individual outlets on and off based on all sorts of different factors, such as temperature, pH, ORP, and a ton more. So while they look quite similar, this one's a controller, this one's a monitor. Controller, monitor. I think you get it. So controllers take monitoring a step further. They can automate the functions of your tank, and they can build in redundancies to protect your livestock. You can break controllers down into two broad categories: single element and multi-element controllers. Single element controllers control one thing and one thing only. For example, a Wi-Fi outlet controls the electricity by turning it on and off. A temperature controller monitors the temperature and can turn either a heater or a fan on and off. Something like the Alcatronic alkalinity controller can both test for and add DKH to your tank. There are many more options for single element controllers out there in the market, but you get the general idea. Many controllers actually come with the product they're controlling, such as light controllers, heater controllers, dosing pump controllers, return pump controllers. You get the idea. And while these things definitely do control something, we don't generally put them in the category of controllers because we reserve that language for standalone products. I'm getting a little bit off track here, but I hope this is starting to make some more sense. But even though there are a lot of single element controllers out there, I would assume that when most of us in this hobby are actually referring to controllers, we're referencing multi-element controllers. There are quite a few different multi-element controllers on the market, such as the Hydros, the GHL controllers, the Mastertronic controller, and the entire suite of Neptune Apex controllers. I'm not gonna list every single reason I can think of, but there are a lot of good reasons why a beginner would want a controller. Phone alerts. If you're away from home and something goes wrong, a controller can send you a text message and an email alerting you of the problem immediately. Power outages, leaks, overflowing skimmer cups, high temperatures, any problem you can program, you can receive an alert for. Temperature control. Since heaters are the most common piece of equipment to fail in this hobby, use your controller to monitor and control the tank's temperature. Number three, feed modes. I have to turn off my wave maker, my return pump, and my skimmer every single time I feed my seahorses. But you can program your controller to turn off all three and turn them all back on in 20 minutes with the press of a single button. Automatic water changes. Pair your controller with dosing pumps to perform precision water changes throughout the entire day so you don't have to do water changes again. And one more reason for a beginner to purchase a controller, redundancy and peace of mind. Build backups for your backups. Never worry again about power outages, leaks, pumps running dry, or a ton of other common issues that happen in this hobby. You can use a controller to build in a ton of redundancies automatically. There are a few good options on the market, such as the Hydros from CoralView, the Profilux from GHL, but none can stand up to the breadth and the depth of the Neptune Systems Apex. The Neptune Systems Apex has tens of additional modules, how-to videos galore, and their own line of pumps, wave makers, lights, dosing pumps, and even a machine called the Trident, which will test the water and dose for you. The only real decision is to go with the full-blown original Apex system or the slightly pared-down Neptune Apex EL. Go with the EL version. It can do everything the full-blown Neptune Apex can do, except it doesn't come with a salinity probe, an ORP probe, or an integrated 0 to 10 volt port. And honestly, I've never needed to monitor my salinity and ORP on a daily basis anyways. But even if you decide to purchase the less expensive EL version, but you want to add those things later on, well, you can always purchase the modules individually and connect them to the EL. Setting up your Neptune Apex controller takes 15 minutes, but I'm not going to show you how. Because I'm a cruel man who delights in your confusion and confuddlement? No, because Thomas already made that video right over here. And as always, everyone, thanks for watching. Happy reefing, be well. We'll see you next time.